2, T-R-U, and Mia X, the biggest mama. Click tight, for life, family ties. That's right, it's bigger than this record shit, nigga. All for one and one for all, that's how we ball. True, forever, that's my family, we bees on top. The cheddar pie, wet you up like the Nile, enemies bleed. In war times, illicit rhymes, illustrated crimes, pucker up, kiss my nine, Nina. Kid, sister, bucking misses and misses for figures. Trick ya, we set you up and then we get you. It's the biggest mama showing love to my sons and brothers. And we gon' blow the roof right off this motherfucker further. Niggas riding with this truth, click it ain't no limit. To my loyalty and strong arm authority. In minutes, I'll finish your day to day soap opera. Downtown hoes, I know we hold your head off in a split.
And how'd you even get into rapping and wanted to rap?
I got into rapping in 1984. Manny Fresh and I, actually, we were in a group. We were young kids, and we were in a group. We had a DJ crew, and we used to throw dances around the city.
Uh-huh.
And I used to do a lot of battle rapping.
All right.
But it wasn't until 92 when I put my first record out.
He, you meet Master P, you know, which set forth a trajectory that,
yes,
you know, probably changed the rest of your life.
Yes.
How did you get his attention?
Okay.
And what did it?
Because in New Orleans, we didn't really know him. You know, we had never...
Because at this point, he's on the West Coast, right?
He's on the West Coast, and yeah, we didn't know him. I dropped a record in 1992 called The Payback. It was a diss record because the boys in New Orleans, they were making all of these records. It was Cash Money, and it was Big Boy. It was Take 4 Records. All of the guys on these labels was dropping these records. The first, The Godfathers of Bounce, Tucker and Herb. And they were calling us all kind of names. So I made this record.
If your man is not forget, my man would do whatever to keep me satisfied. Putting in all types of work, showing me just what I was worth. To him, yeah, mama, I'm in love with a gangster and he's coming home. And he knows I've been strong.
So the record was at like maybe 28,000. When Master P came back home for a visit. But he came, I was working at Peaches Records in a record store.
Okay, I'm up on that.
He came to Peaches, yes, the oldest mom and pops in America.
They still there, right?
That's right.
That's beautiful.
So he was looking for a lady rapper to join TRU, the rap group.
Being the original true member was awesome, man. That was my group, man. I don't know why Master P chose to kick me out from Mill X. I don't understand that. Never did, never will.
And everybody was telling him, you have to hear Mia X.
But anyway, that was my group, and let me tell you, I was down for them guys.
So I had clocked out and went home. Scarface was having a concert. I went to wash and set my hair so I could go to the concert. Master P came to my house. I was under the dryer. And he was talking to me from the dryer saying, you know, yo, my label is going to be like the biggest in the world. And I'm under the dryer and I'm like, my hair is so thick, it's going to take forever to dry. But how long you in town? He's like, I'm here. So I'm like, well, tomorrow, let's link up. Everything P said, I felt truth in it. I felt that he was going to do something that was going to shake hip hop up. You could just feel it coming off him. I don't know if it was the vibe, the drive. I had a couple of labels after me at the time, but it was something about the way he said, I'm about to change this thing.
I understand, though, you didn't even have a real contract with Master P because you guys were friends, right?
No, we didn't have a contract. We did it, you know, just on a handshake. Like, you know, I promise I will not run all around and record with other people and violate the standard recording agreements. If you promise to pay me what you said, you're going to pay me.
You're kidding. And that's how it went
and
down.
And that's pretty much the way it went down. And so, you know, I came on as an artist,
yeah,
and a writer. And, you know, together we did 75 million records worldwide.
Oh, my goodness.
So we linked up. We went in a studio. I did a couple of ad-libs for him on his 99 Ways to Die album. And then he was like, you need to come out to California, you know, and we need to work. So that's what we did.
Hey, now let's talk about your first of all, let's talk about your career as a rapper. You first put out an EP.
Yeah.
What EP? That was, yeah, mm-hmm. And the name of it was?
Good Girl Gone Bad.
The Good Girl Gone Bad. What was that all about?
Not bad meaning bad, but bad meaning good. Okay. It was all good.
It's all good.
Yeah, representing for the sisters and all the real brothers out there. Well, from being unladylike, you know, you're labeled when you take care of your business, mm-hmm. if you're able to function and make productive decisions, work, handle yours, go for yours. In a world of big, big fish, that's considered unladylike by a lot of chauvinists. So here I am, unladylike. I do what I gotta do. I do what they do, and it's all good.
I cut you.
That's right.
I cut you. That's the roof,
man. I shoot you. That's the roof.
But I was pretty popular all over the South by the time I met Master P. I was already doing shows in Texas and in Florida. You know, I had already put my foot all the way down in hip-hop. So
I'm excited about all the projects coming up. I feel it's our time. We worked hard. A lot of people didn't know about us, but we here. They recognize now, you know.
Right.
I'm happy for everybody. I'm really proud of P because he's been putting in a lot of work.
Coming to No Limit, it was a win-win for both of us because we both had this drive to make the label grow. And when I got to L.A., it was like, now let's go to Richmond. We go to Richmond. We meet all these producers. I did some records, and then I was like, listen, South, you got to let me go get you some producers
so that
I could really do me. We need KL. And so then he met KL and Bout It was born.
Punks play your head because they should be punk. But I dunk a nigga's head into a toilet full of piss. Cause in this drama field, but we ain't taking no shit. Downtown, six wall, love feet on guard. Seven wall, hard heads, niggas out that St. Bernard. Night wall, press, hawk, desire, and Florida, New Orleans. So bout it, every day we coming hard on fire. Water got them niggas getting high off my flows. Gumbo, re-green, plus my A2 fake. Got them paying 20 bones. So bring it on, cause I got it recognized. No limit in me, your ex nigga flex if you got it, bout it. You bout it, yeah, I'm bout it. And rest in peace, my girl Jill, cause she was bout it.
Now, KL, was he part of the Medicine Men?
Yes.
Yo, the Medicine Men.
They were Beats by the Pound first.
Right. Okay, so Beats by the Pound, that starts coming together. And, yo, like, sonically, what y'all were doing production-wise?
Monopolize on everything we see. Keep pistols drawn and cocked. We got the industry locked. We can't be stopped. Too hot to check the spots that we got on Billboard. Detention set up roadblocks. We fading all you want some more. Then let's go.
And that's when it really shut it down.
Yeah. Like I said, when he said he was going to change the game, I felt truth in that. That part right there, you just felt it. And so, being a lady like a mama, I helped him to assemble my children. Come on, Fiend, and come on, Mac, and come on, Cain and Abel, and come on, Beats by the Pound.
All the time, I keep my mind on my money and all business that applies to me. But I got to have a boss hog nigga beside me. He confides in me because he knows I ain't about seeing him stressed. I showed him proof I can hold water on these 40 deep breaths. We've been through so many war zones, but we made it back home. Singing that we won, we shot him down, so ripping on the chrome. I got it gone with this bomb lying between my thighs. I'm a rider, so I ride, and we cruises all night. We hit the life, baby boy, it's just you and me. I don't care about your felonies on empty rap sheets. I want your babies. Should ride with mama in the Mercedes. Them hoes is crazy, trying to sweat you when they know I'm your lady.
You now, brought all those
Moby
guys
Dick
to the
was
table.
His cousin, so he was already with Percy, and Mr. Servon was his friend, but the other players in the game, Soldier Slim, and then it was like, look, bro, you need to go get Mystical.
You bought me, you the one that recommended Mystical?
Like, yes, you need to say, bro, nah, you need to, Snoop hollering at you, you need to go get Snoop.
I have a favorite moment, and it was when I met Charlie Wilson. Mm. My mom's favorite record was Yearning for Your Love by the Gap Band.
Okay.
And I went to Snoop's house to cook some chicken and macaroni.
What?
Because that's Snoop's favorite chicken wings
and
macaroni.
Cook it back then.
So I went to cook him some. And Uncle Charlie was there, and I was like, my mom loves Yearning for Your Love. If I rewrite it, can we record it? He said, let's do it now.
Stop it.
And boom, we did it.
I used to cook up dope, rob with niggas, know about the hits, hang with killers, take the broads down for the jailhouse visits, keep my bed warm with a cutthroat nigga, have the car parties where the stakes was high, go shopping, hit the club and then start a ride. I never had a day without no drama, half the OGs age, but they call me mama. Had the ganja overstuck in a hefty bag, orange pills to kill the smell, slinging with my dad. I never thought about my life, I swear y'all for real, until my best friend Jill got killed. And then I dropped to my knees and called on the Lord. Please change my ways, cause I'm living too hard and too fast. I'm gonna raise a child when I'm out here buck wild. I had to slow down.
Like, you know, the average mom would have never known all that.
Right.
And shout out to Moby Dick, a guy who I feel like was ahead of his time.
Wait, if you go back and pull the Gangsta Harmony album or listen to any of the hooks he did on the No Limit stuff, yeah, he was definitely
ahead. Is he easy
guy
to get a hold of these days?
Yes. Well, actually, we are working on an album, me, him, KL, and Mr. Servon.
One morning, tears in my eyes. The feds kicked in my door and caught me and my baby by surprise. We got popped, but they didn't find no dope. They said it was conspiracy, just cause a hater said so. Now we might do time in the pen, but the state don't have a case without witnesses and no evidence. So I guess once again that it's on.
Three ends and abroad. That's what we used to call our house because we lived in an apartment together in California, you know, struggling. Like, man, we was making way more money in New Orleans, but we got to put our grind down.
Chase that dream.
And build this label, and that's what happened.
Dance floor, what you came for? Acting like you didn't know that I blow everything overnight with a big pot of pound at the ice cream shop. They finally dropped the first label on that no big tank. And I'ma act a blown fool, baby. Thank God I ain't. You can't see me even if you had a bird's eye view. With my focus, cause my focus just go.
So you watched the No Limit thing go to astronomical heights. Around what time did you feel like things were slowing down with that particular move?
I told KL, we got to do a record and we got to flip it so this dude don't be a joke.
It's always for tot. Primo, what you giving dope away, you front motherfuckers? Bitch!
All right, so tell us about the cookbook. What made you want to do this?
Well, my grandmother was known for saying so many outrageous things on top of being an excellent cook. And I spent so much time in the kitchen with her and talking to her about my problems. And so when I was sitting down thinking about her one day, because she passed in 2001, I decided to put some of the things that she said to me when I was going through certain things, as well as some of her recipes in a book.
All right, nice. So is this one of them?
I like to season up and let things marinate
what
a little bit.
What you got seasoning on?
So let me tell you, this is my concoction.
Oh.
I like to take a lot of dry spices and play on them. So if you have dry spices in your house, onion powder, garlic powder, Creole seasoning,
just
paprika,
throw them all together?
Just throw it all together.
I
you
love
know,
it.
Let that hang out for a while.
Okay.
But,
all right, nice.
Yeah, so, you know, nah.
And how long does it take to make in real life? Because, you know, we're in TV world, so.
So I'm going to tell y'all, in real life, it takes like about an hour and a half.
Ooh.
And I'm gonna tell you why. Because when you cook in your roux, you wanna cook it like 20 or 30 minutes so it can brown.
Okay. All right, guys. You stir and I will take us to break.
Well, no pain, no pain, no pain, no pain, no gain.
Mama,
no
man,
gain.
Some strong women.
Oh,
you
no
gonna
pain,
give us strong
no
women
pain,
again.
No pain, no pain,
no pain.
I know it's hard cause every day it's a struggle, huh? Being both mommy and daddy, trying to hustle now any way you can just to bring home the bacon. Baby daddy faking and keeping your head aching. Taking off a job, paying $4.65 an hour. Feeling like slaves cause the white man still holds the power. But your strength will devour soon, remember that. Because we God's children strong, fearless and black. Fact remains it's still harder than the mother. Lord, how long they gonna try to keep